We're up here today below the recreational dam. They got the water up. It's really running, as you can see in the background. It's really running pretty good. But it can still be good when it's up. In fact, I'd rather fish it when it's high and when it's up. Maybe not this high. It's a little bit more than what I really enjoy fishing. I like for it to be down just a couple, maybe about 3 or 4 foot than what it is now. But when the water is up like this, I really have better success. And another reason is, look around. There's not hardly anybody. There's nobody up here except me. Like, there's nobody up here at all. And that's why I like fishing. when it's not flowing high, you usually have quite a few people up here crappie fishing around the banks here and the catfishing. But when it's up like this, a lot of times people just stay away because they really don't know how to fish this type of water. But when you really know how to fish this type of water right here, you can really do some good, especially on these big hybrid stripes. And walleye, just a lot of different species of fish. Looks like a lot of gars up in here today. Looks like it. I'm seeing a bunch of them on my Polaroid glasses. Right out of, just all up down through here. You know, a lot of people don't like to fish. Like I said, a lot of people don't like to fish when it's like this. But if you use the right lures, especially big weighted lures, and I've got a pretty big size swim bait on here, and you want something that'll really cut through that water and you can work in that water. Light lures just don't work very well in this fast moving water. But if you can get something that's pretty heavy and get right through there, a lot of times it works a lot better. Gets you a good casting reel, bait caster, some good line. All that is important when you're trying to fish this stuff. Oh, what do we got here? Something or another. Might be a, I don't know what. Oh. Come on. What do we got? What do we got? Oh. Oh, I hope this is what I think it is, but I just don't know. Whatever it is, it's big. Oh, what is this? A big spoonbill. Got it snagged. Look at that. Big spoonbill. Got him snagged right in the back. Oh man, holy buckets. I think that's about the biggest one I've ever caught up here. Well, I ain't caught him yet. Get the net here. Come here. Get his old. Good Lord, can't even get his bill in the. Can't even get his bill in the net. Let me see if I can scoop him. Come here. Let me see if I'm pulling him. There you go. As you can see, What a mouth that sucker's got. I don't think I've ever had Well, that was a fun fight, but it really is not what we're after. And I got my line all tangled up here. You know, when a fish pulls that hard and rips out drag and you fight him for a bit, you know, it don't really matter what he is, does it? It's just fun to be out here catching them things that'll pull like that. I don't particularly care for catfish as far as eating them, but I sure like catching them. Usually I catch a couple of big flatheads every time I come up here on this lure right here. And I've caught some spoonbill like that too. Actually, I caught a smaller spoonbill than that the other day I was up here, and I caught it on a jig, and I actually hooked it in the mouth. He actually bit it and caught him. And so, you know, but usually you snag them, but sometimes you'll catch them. They're ugly. What we got here? I hope we got something good. Yes, I think we do. Do we? I think we do. We got an eating size white bass, and that's what we want. That's what we're wanting. I'd like to have a few of them. Yeah, if I could have a few of them right there, we'd have a good day. We'll put him right on the string. Oh my good night. What in the world? Oh my good Lord, I don't know what that was. Man, he started like stripping out drag and broke my line. Holy cow. I mean, that was whatever it was. It was big and it was mean and that was not a striper, I'll tell you that. It hit like, it was just like a, just, man, it was running out through there. Holy cow, that was a big, big fish, whatever that was. Did you see that? It was just like, I thought I was gonna run out of line. I had to put a little pressure on him. Wow. That didn't even act like, I've never seen nothing like that. I mean, that went like straight for them, for the middle. I mean, that was running straight for the middle and broke 12 pound test line. Phew, that was big, whatever it was. Well, good morning, everybody. We're back up here for the next day, trying to see if we can finish out this fishing video. It's been a little bit rough. Yesterday was kind of rough, as you saw. Didn't do very, very good yesterday, but thought I'd come back up here this morning and try morning time, see how it goes, and kind of see if we can do a little bit better and catch a few more and finish this video out. This has been a 3-day thing trying to get this video completed, but yeah, it's still fun. So the water is down about 2 foot from what it was yesterday. I think yesterday it was up to about 10 foot, and I think it's probably about, looks like it's about 8 this morning. So, I don't know how it's going to affect them. Sometimes when it drops like this, though, it's a little bit better. I'd rather fish it when it's about, maybe about, like I said, 2 foot lower, 2 or 3 foot lower than this. But we're just going to keep chunking and winding here and see if we can catch something. little bit more humid than it was yesterday. So I think it's going to be a hot one today too. So I don't know how that's going to affect it. Sometimes you just got to get up here and brave whatever elements you got. Because they're here, especially when they're running this water like this, you know, it just keeps them moving. Fighting. Oh my god, it's a big striper. Holy cow. Oh my god. This thing is huge. Oh my god, this thing's huge. Oh, Lord, don't let me. Don't let me lose him. Oh my God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Look at this. Oh, now that's what we're after. That right there is what we're after. Look at that. Holy cow. That's what we're after right there. Oh yeah. God, I love these things, man. I mean, he fought like crazy. I thought it was a catfish at first, the way he was acting, but we get two or three of them, I'll call it a good day. It's already a good day catching one of them, but Definitely a good day. This is another one. I hope. this ain't the best footage in the world, but we got us a walleye. A nice one too. Yeah. Look at that. Best eating fish in the river. All right. That was worth the day already right there. Catching that big hybrid and this one. You got some good eating right there. I lost something over there. I don't know what it was, but I lost another fish over there. But maybe they'll start hitting here and we can catch a limit. A walleye. Look at that. Number two. All right. That's what we want. Yes. Oh. All right. One more. That's all I needed. Yes. Look at that, folks. The camera is going to die. All right. All right. All right. Look at that. Yeah. Man, the camera was going to die. It's flashing. But I'm glad we got that one. All right. All right. Good day. Well, I think that's a pretty good morning right there. Got two big hybrids and two big walleyes and lost a few more. But as you can see, I don't know how good the camera pick it up, but that's a pretty good haul. Oh. So. Well, it took about 3 days to make this video, but I hope you enjoyed it. I like fishing these fast waters, especially below these dams. You know, it scares a lot of people off. They really don't know how to fish it. But if you know how to fish it, use the right equipment. You know, get you a fast reel that you can really burn that lure through the water and make a lot of noise. Get you some big lures, ounce, bigger than that even, where it can really churn up a bunch of water and makes all the difference in the world. Use bright colors. I was using chartreuse, mostly white. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. I know the footage today isn't that great because the water was coming up and I had to put the camera up high and just kind of point it toward me. But I did get some on my GoPro and on the camera too. So I know the footage ain't the best in the world, but you got to keep the camera safe. I didn't want to be over there or over here and the water come up and me not paying attention and it goes floating down the river. But anyways, it's always good to be out here and fish, especially during summer like this, where you're right between deer season and turkey season. So we're going to get to the house and clean these fish and I'm tired. I need something cold to drink. I got to stop at the store up here and get something to drink. My arm is actually sore. I caught two other big ones off camera, flatheads, catfish, and I caught a big drum and hooked a big carp. And so they really fought me too. So my arm is a little bit tired of throwing that heavy lure and catching the bigger fish. But anyways, take a moment, subscribe to this channel. And you know, it's not a big fishing channel, but it's mostly turkey hunting, deer hunting, but deer season will be here before you know it. So if you're a big deer hunter or you're a big turkey hunter, stay tuned to the channel. Got a lot. Go back and look at the old stuff if you're new and this is the first time you've ever been seen one of my videos. And I really appreciate it. And I appreciate all your support. Stay tuned to the next video.